just to prove that Capture Pilot with camera controls works with other cameras, not just phase one. I'm gonna plug in my D3. But I'm quite sure this will work with other cameras as well. Many of the very popular DSLRs. Have a look at Capture One online to see if your camera's on there. Okay. Here's my D3. Completely standard, just got this yesterday. That's the port for the USB. That is my USB cable. One end into the computer. And the little bitty teeny weeny end into my camera. Done. Okay, so I've plugged my Nikon D3S in. You saw that earlier. Here's my iPad. Let's open up the iPad. Capture Pilot. Choose phase one thing from today. And look, we've got the camera control for the Nikon D3S on that floating pallet. So let's take a shot. I'm gonna point it back towards Vita, who's actually doing the filming right now. So Vita, you just go down a little bit lower. That's it. That's it, that's good. Hold it there, Vita, and you can see coming up there on the screen there and coming up on here will actually be a shot of Vita. And there she is. And who said Germans don't have a sense of humor? You can see here, I've got my floating palette and I can control my aperture with this dial wheel. I can control my shutter speed. I can control my ISO. And I can also choose the program that the camera's shooting on. I can choose my file format. And also with the Nikon D3, I can also choose the sensor area or size that I wish to use. The other thing as well that's rather cool is if you don't want to use the dials to adjust things, you can simply press on here and get a drop-down menu and choose your aperture that way. Same thing here. And also on the ISO. So once again, it's a great example of Capture One and Phase One giving you lots and lots of choice.